Welcome to 10 cool things that you might not know about in GTA in 2020. Now you may be thinking, GTA has been out for 6 years, almost 7 this year. I know everything there is to know. Well, you'd actually be surprised because even though GTA has been out for this long, there are some things that people still, I don't know how, they still don't know about, such as how to get the HUD view in a helicopter or jet. I mean, literally just go into the settings, have a look and you'll find it. But anyway, I'm going to show you how because no one knows how to do it for some reason. So guys, first of all, you want to get into a helicopter. Now, I've already done this trick before. As you can see, I'm already in the view. But what you want to do to make it so you can get this view as well is go to your settings, go to camera, and go down to where it says vehicle HUD. And now, your camera view is just like mine was. See, when you change it, it changes your vehicle HUD view. Shocking. Number 2. Another thing people don't know about GTA is that it's not illegal to kill other people. Now, contrary to what Reddit, sucker joke, will let you know, GTA 5 is not just about doing missions. Now, this clip was taken from the GTA Online trailer.
Just what you choose to do in that world is up to you.
That means we don't have to follow your rules about not killing random players. Okay, now I don't want this to be a rant, this is just like, just a bit of fun. But if someone fights you, you don't actually have to fight them back. You can go passive, you can leave the session, and you can get into solo lobbies, which is what I'm going to show you how to do now. Also quickly, before all you keyboard warriors get in, if Rockstar didn't want to kill each other, they wouldn't like promote killing like all the time. Literally like bounties, free mode events, free admissions, CO missions, MC work, literally everything like promotes PvP, so yeah. So guys, if you're on PS4, you're going to want to go to Network, Setup Internet Connection, and it doesn't matter which you're on, Ethernet, Wi-Fi, you go on whichever one, go to Custom, then just do the top one for all of these, except for MTU, and then you want to change this to 800. And once you've got that, test your internet, should work fine. Then when you go into an online session, it should be just you in that session, which means you can do CO work and stuff. Unfortunately, I don't have an Xbox, so I can't show you how to do that, but if you just Google or search Xbox Solo Public Lobby, GTA 5 or something like that, you'll definitely find a tutorial. If you're on PC, go to Resource, Monitor, then go to Network, might take a while like mine did, and go to GTA. I'm just going to do it with Chrome because I can't be able to load GTA, and then just suspend it for like 10 seconds and then like unsuspend it, and then you should be in a solo session. And you can like CO, MC work in solo sessions, by the way.
Number 3.
Okay, so this clip has been taken from another tutorial, but it might help in this video, so I'm going to include it anyway. So, yeah. Now the setting you'll want to turn off is in display on console. I'll show a video clip of it here. On PC, it's under post effects. And it's called in-game depth of field effects. Now if you're trying to snipe someone, it makes things seem blurry. If you're not aiming directly at them, as you can see, it takes a while to adjust. If you turn that off, there's no change in focus and everything's sharp. Doesn't look as nice, but it helps a lot when fighting. Number 4. So if you watch like Met Pro, they do it quite a lot. This tip is basically, you can use a flare gun to guide homing rockets away from you. So if you're in like a vehicle without any weapons, yeah, just get your flare gun out and then hopefully you won't die. It also works if you're on ground, so if you, I don't know, if someone's in a buzzard trying to grief you or something, just shoot your flare gun and hopefully they don't hit you. You have to get the timing right though. You could also maybe try and get the homing missile to turn around and hit them. I haven't seen it done before, but you never know, it might happen. Number 5. Okay, this tip is quite well known, but some people might not know it. Basically, if you shoot the rotor of a helicopter, you can take it down a lot quicker than if you shoot the actual helicopter itself, and they just spin out uncontrollably. and it's quite a useful thing to know if you're getting followed by a helicopter.
Should I turn the thing around?
Just shoot the rotor out.
There we go.
Now, if you noticed, I wasn't shooting the actual rotor bit there, I was shooting the metal bit. If the helicopter was the other way around, shooting the metal bit would work, but in this instance, you had to shoot the actual rotor. Number 6. Now, a lot of people should know this trick already, but it's basically whenever you're going to get a jet for the military base, if you fly low, then like enemy jets from the military base, they won't shoot at you. So it just helps you get out quicker. So as you can see, just flying around low, I don't have anyone chasing me in the jet. But as soon as I try to pull up and go above like a certain barrier, then I get a jet shooting at me. Number 7. Now this is a teleport glitch you can only do on PC, and basically how you do it is you need to turn on jobs on your map. Now once you've done that, go to the map and go to a place where you want to teleport to and find the nearest job. Now what you want to do is press space. This doesn't work on controller, by the way. You press space to join the job. While you're in the clouds, you want to spam right click, and then when that message pops up, you press enter and it will tell you to quit the job and you should spawn where that job was. Now you can also do this with custom jobs, so if you make your own job, like I've made this one here called Maze Bank Spawn, which is on top of the Maze Bank. If I go to my map and go to the Maze Bank, you can see I have a job there. And all I have to do is do the same thing as before, press space, join it, spam right click, then when the message pops up, quit, and then I should be on top of the Maze Bank. Yeah, there we go. See, on top of the Maze Bank. Number 8. So this bit isn't really like a PvP tip or something like that. But basically, this building, the construction site, it has a middle area, which I'm going to parachute down to now, that is covered from above. So that means you can't get dive bombed by lasers, hydras, or like B-11s. It's also covered from below, so people can't shoot rockets up. Also, the fact that it's covered from above means that you can't get auto-cannoned, which I'll show later. And also you can shoot out of the windows, or not out of the windows, out of the netting, but rockets can't come through, so if someone wants to fire rockets at you, they won't hit. They'll just hit the netting, but your bullets can come out, so it's pretty useful. And here I'm getting autocannoned, but nothing happens. I'm safe. Number 9. Okay, so if you're a tryhard, or like no PvP a lot, you'll definitely know this trick. This is just a fast reload. Basically what you have to do is you have to shoot a gun, like an RPG, switch to a sticky bomb, or it works with any other weapon, but sticky bomb means you switch fastest, and then you switch back and it's reloaded for you. So as you can see, if you do it quick, it's like this. Now a lot of people seem to think I'm hacking when I'm doing this in public, so hopefully if you guys see this, I'm not hacking, this is just a tip, and I'm also not using macros, I'm using it legit. It also works with the heavy sniper, which is quite useful. So if you need to reload in the middle of a fight, you can just quick switch. Bonus tip. I don't know how many people know this, but basically if you want to change what session type you're in, just go to creator, and there you can go to an invite only session, public session, crew session, and also change your aiming type to like auto aim or free aim. So yeah, that might be useful for some people. Don't know, but yeah. Number 10. Now this is a gunfight tip that I've sort of lost muscle memory for. So whenever I get into an AR fight, I usually forget to do it. But basically it's crouching while you move left and right. Because when the other person crouches and you move the right stick up to like aim to the head, it actually doesn't aim to the head. It aims to just next to it. So when they're running around, it's like hard to hit the head, and you have to aim to the left. So yeah, that's been it. If you found something new, drop a like. If you didn't, comment down below something that you think other players might not know. Yeah, thanks for watching. Bye. Spilling over more, until I over